Hello and welcome to this painting tutorial video. Today I will explain to you my techniques and recipe for painting the gold armor for one of my Shovel Knight board game miniature. I start with Command Green, directly on top of the black primer. As the armor is complex, I opt for a size 2 fine brush to apply this base color. It allows me to work quickly but precisely to establish areas of light and shadow. To do this, I leave parts of the armor black where there is shadow, either in the hollows or the core shadows that separate the direct light from the reflected light. Next, I use Japanese brown to give a first shade of yellow over the command green. I chose this yellow because of its brownish color, which blends well with the khaki green. These two earthy colors are perfect as a base for the desaturated gold I'm trying to build. With Japanese brown, I can better determine the areas of light throughout the armor, both direct and reflected. Command green then becomes an intermediate color towards shadow. You can have fun leaving small areas of green to give the impression of objects around the model that would slightly block the light, like the branches of a tree. You don't need to think about it too much, as this environment only exists in your head, unless you're creating a diorama or a backdrop. I continue with Ochre to further brighten the armor's luminosity. I work on smaller areas or on the edges of the armor. I take a little more time with this color, as I only apply it on the side of the point of light. It's at this point that I separate direct light from reflected light, the latter being weaker by nature. I dilute the ochre to make it translucent and use it as a glaze to refine the outline of the parts of the armor where the light is reflected. With ivory, I push the values of the armor's brightness even further. Then, with white, I put even more emphasis on these points of light with precise line or dots, simply to draw the eye and give the armor the impression of brilliance. You can give your armor a more matte appearance by having wider, more diffuse centers of light. Concentrating so much light in one spot on each piece of armor gives it a clean, polished effect. It's a quick and easy recipe that you can adapt to your needs. I hope you enjoyed my explanations. I invite you to send me your comments and ideas for future tutorials. Thank you for liking this video. Subscribe to my channel to support my work and help me produce more content to help you back with your projects. Enjoy!